Over the last couple of decades, electric cars have evolved from being an alternative form of transportation to the cornerstone of every major car company's product roadmap. To take EVs to the next level of efficiency, developers the world over are on the quest for better batteries. But it's a bit of a paradox. Adding more and bigger batteries may give the car more power and range, but it'll also add weight, which can actually reduce the overall efficiency. It's a bit of a paradox. But what if there is a way to integrate the battery into the structure of the car itself so that it doesn't contribute any additional weight at all? Could this really make our EVs more efficient? Will they be safe? And would there be any trade-offs? We thought these questions deserve a deeper dive today on Two Bit da Vinci. Special thanks to Aura for sponsoring the show. The future with the metaverse and NFTs can seem daunting, but protecting your digital identity doesn't have to be with Aura. When it comes to vehicle efficiency, weight is a major factor. The heavier an object is, the more energy it takes to get it to move. If you've ever lifted weights at the gym, you know what I'm talking about. I do it all the time. This creates a bit of a paradox with vehicles, especially battery-powered ones. Bigger batteries weigh more, meaning they will eat up more of the power they provide. It's a vicious cycle. Right now, EV batteries consume a large portion of the car's overall weight. Take a Tesla Model S, for example. Their batteries weigh about 544 kilograms, just under 1,200 pounds. With a total vehicle weight of 2,241 kilograms, the batteries alone comprise almost a quarter of the car's total mass, and that's with no passengers or payload of any kind. The problem isn't just the battery's weight, it's that the weight doesn't contribute any load-bearing functions to the rest of the vehicle. So if we need more energy storage and less weight, we have a few choices. Use more exotic materials to lower the weight of the car, leaving more weight for batteries. Or develop more energy-dense batteries with more energy per unit of mass. The sensitivity to vehicle weight is so great that the EPA estimates that just a 10% reduction in vehicle weight could result in 6 to 8% boosts in fuel efficiency. But what if there was a way to take better advantage of all that dead weight? What if the batteries themselves could literally do more than just pull their own weight around? That is exactly the idea behind structural zero-mass batteries. Where typical EV batteries today are built in sequence and stored at the bottom of the chassis, a structural battery is, as the name suggests, worked into the overall structure of the vehicle. These batteries are often dubbed zero mass, because in essence, the battery's weight disappears as it's woven directly into the load-bearing structure. Major breakthroughs in structural battery technology have recently been achieved by a team of researchers at the Chalmers University of Technology in Sweden. Before we dive into this team and talk about their breakthrough, let's talk a little bit about where the idea for structural batteries came from. Structural power sources have been utilized in aerospace technology for decades. Transport and high-performance aircraft commonly have their fuel source built into the wings or fuselage of the craft. An airplane in flight is kind of like a gymnast with outstretched arms supporting their weight on the rings. If they could just cut off their legs and torso and stick that weight closer to their arms, then maybe even I could be a gymnast. This is in essence what fuel in the wings does for an aircraft. So, if we have already seen this technology in action, why haven't we applied it to EVs yet? So in essence, either an aircraft in flight or a gymnast on the rings had their load-bearing forces on the wingtips and all the mass in the center. And that means that you have a lot more torque and weight and fatigue and strain on all the parts. By putting the weight closer to where the lift comes from, all of that is decreased. So if we have already seen this technology in action, why haven't we applied it to EVs yet? The quest for better integrating fuel sources into vehicle design is a rabbit that researchers have been chasing for a while. Back in 2007, the US Army Research Laboratory began experiments to develop a structural battery composite using carbon fiber lamina as the electrode. This research acted as a springboard for researchers at Chalmers University who have finally produced just such a battery. One benefit of EVs that doesn't get enough attention is saying goodbye to gas stations, which means saying goodbye to swiping your credit card and risking some hacker stealing your card information. Yeah, that actually happens. But what about your digital security? Luckily, our sponsor this week is Aura. With online account security, Aura will alert you if your login information is compromised. As much as you might protect your info, it's still stored on some company servers where hackers are constantly trying to break in. They also protect you financially by monitoring your social security number for bank fraud threats and unauthorized wire transactions. What I love about Aura is that it has everything you need in one app. It even includes a password manager to allow you to create crazy custom passwords and manage them all in one place. And also device and network protection with antivirus software and Wi-Fi security to protect you online. Best of all, get a family plan, and this blanket of protection extends to everyone in your family. Plans even come with up to $1 million in identity theft insurance for eligible losses. So take the guesswork out of being safe online and check out Aura. Use my link, aura.com/2bit, and save 40% and start saving with a free trial today. Huge thanks to Aura and all of you for supporting the show. One key element in developing a structural battery has been landing on the right materials. In the past, structures that proved structurally sound, being lightweight and strong, often lacked the proper electrical properties to make a good battery, and vice versa. But according to Chalmers professor and project lead, Leif Asp, introducing and utilizing carbon fiber has allowed the team to design a structural battery that checks all the boxes, possessing competitive energy storage and structural integrity. So how does a structural battery work? It begins with a positive electrode made of lithium phosphate coated aluminum foil. The negative electrode is made out of carbon fiber, which serves as a host for the lithium storing energy, while also providing strength and rigidity. Because carbon fiber is a great electrical conductor, it helps reduce the weight even further by eliminating the need for additional copper or silver to act as a conductor. A fiberglass fabric in a matrix electrolyte developed by KTH Royal Institute of Technology separates the electrodes. This electrolyte helps transport lithium ions between the two electrodes while also helping transfer mechanical loads between carbon fibers and other parts of the vehicle. Now, let's talk efficiency. Right now, the battery has an energy density of around 24 watt hours per kilogram, which is 10 times better than previous versions. But to put that in perspective, the 2170 cells in the Tesla Model 3 and Y have batteries with 246 watt hours per kilogram. And Tesla claims their future 4680 cells will come in at 285. So at first glance, it doesn't seem like the structural battery packs stack up very well against competition, does it? But this is where it's time to think like an engineer. While the batteries may not have the same energy density as some of its more dedicated cousins, remember, they don't have to. Besides storing energy, these components also double as structure. So any energy storage benefit is really just a bonus, one that could reduce the weight of dedicated batteries required. The EPA even estimates that replacing cast iron and traditional steel components with lightweight materials could reduce the weight of a vehicle's body and chassis by about 50%. Now, integrating a battery into the vehicle structure alone won't make a difference quite on that scale, at least not right away. But by proving the viability of such a design, we're moving closer and closer to that reality. At Battery Day in 2020, Tesla not only revealed their new 4680 battery cells, but a new architecture that will integrate the cell into the future vehicle design. Think of Tesla's battery as structural battery light. The battery isn't built into the vehicle's entire structure. Instead, it's able to reduce exterior packaging, making the dedicated battery area stiffer and lighter. This innovative feature promises to reduce the number of parts needed to construct these designs while also being able to bring down the total mass of the battery pack. Tesla projects that this design can bring vehicle weight down by roughly 10% and could increase battery range by roughly 14%. When it comes to vehicle structure, one element tends to make the highest priority, and that's safety. In the event of an accident, how safe will my battery be? And more importantly, how safe will I be? It turns out, the carbon fiber structural batteries may be as safe or even safer than most of the cars on the road today. The structures measure a stiffness of 25 gigapascals and a tensile strength exceeding 300 megapascals, meaning the structure is comparable to other commonly used construction materials. Tesla's battery pack also utilizes a hexagonal honeycomb design, similar to designs used in aerospace and other vehicles. The BMW i3 uses a similar design structure for crash absorption around the vehicle's battery pack. So are we going to start seeing EVs outfitted with zero mass structural batteries in the near future? Tesla is expected to use their new battery format in Cybertrucks, which could be a major win for the future of heavy-duty EVs. The batteries will also be utilized in future Model Ys, but the more ambitious total structural battery is likely to be much further away. Currently, carbon fiber vehicle structure is reserved for only the most demanding and expensive applications. Vehicles like the million-dollar McLaren Senna and the ultra-modern Boeing 787 Dreamliner both use extensive carbon fiber structure to great benefit, but at great cost. That's because currently, carbon fiber is a much more expensive material to work with. Metals such as steel and aluminum are derived from raw ore, which is then formed or fabricated into end products using time-tested and standardized processes, like casting, where molten metal is poured into dies, or forging, where compressive forces are used to shape metal. In contrast, carbon fiber is pretty complex, requiring a series of carbon layers laid up in an alternating weave pattern. Then a binding agent is applied and everything is vacuum sealed and hardened into the desired pattern. This makes it much more time-intensive and harder to mass-produce. If true structural batteries are to gain prominence, they will have to be developed alongside new carbon fiber techniques. In fact, perhaps it's the ability to not only be structural, but also store energy that might give engineers the motivation to further pursue the use of carbon fiber. The Chalmers battery has also inspired other researchers, like scientists from the Swedish National Space Agency. Their project replaces the aluminum foil in the positive electrode with carbon fiber, which will help increase energy density as well as stiffness. The fiberglass separator will also be substituted by an ultra-thin variant, which should allow for faster charging cycles. If they succeed, this team of researchers believes that this battery could reach a stiffness of 75 gigapascals with an energy density of 75 watt hours per kilogram. Pretty incredible. However, the team doesn't expect their research to reach any conclusions for at least another 2 years, and the Chalmers battery is also a ways off from production. Still, this research is all heading in the right direction, finding innovative solutions to some of the biggest roadblocks facing EVs today. And with companies like Tesla already rallying behind these kinds of breakthroughs, we move ever closer to the day where everyone is driving an electric vehicle. But what do you think? Should EVs follow aircraft and integrating batteries into their structural design? Let us know in the comments below. So that is a look at the zero mass battery. As you can tell, we're still outside. Our studio is not ready yet, hopefully in January, but bear with us and all the noise and everything else. Thank you so much for watching. If you want to be a rockstar supporter of this show, please consider becoming a 2-Bit Tribe member, either a patron on Patreon or a YouTube channel member. Your support really makes your show possible, and we really appreciate you guys. All right, so take a look around. There's some other videos that we think you're going to love. And just remember, the future is going to be awesome.